Our topic for today, understanding commitment. 1 Corinthians 6:19 to 20. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit, who is in you, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. You were bought at a price. Therefore, honor God with your body. Ipinapaalala po sa atin ng verses na binasa natin today na pag tinanggap na natin si Jesus bilang ating personal Lord and Savior, we belong to the Lord. Our lives, they now belong to Him. And because we have accepted this, because we've made this decision, we've made this commitment, pinahalagahan natin ang relationship natin sa God. We even say to Him that we love Him. At hindi lang ito lip service. We love God because we do something about this love. Ipinapakita natin na love talaga natin si God. May mga ginagawa tayo because of our love for God. Tulad ni Jesus, anong sinabi niyang mahal niya tayo, hindi lang niya ito sinabi binigkas bilang lip service. Ngunit ipinakita niya ang kanyang pagmamahal, ipinakita niya ang kanyang commitment sa pagmamahal din sa atin in a very tangible way. Yan ay tinuturo sa atin ng verse na ito sa Biblia. 1 John 3:16. This is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down His life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers. Nang itinuturo sa atin dito, real commitment is costly. We must remember the price Jesus paid because of His love and commitment for us. To understand commitment, we need to see its price. Because a committed person, like Jesus Christ, knows commitment requires our presence, meaning our time. Jesus gave us His time on earth. Philippians chapter 2, verse 5 to 8. Your attitude should be the same as that of Christ Jesus, who, being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped, but made Himself nothing, taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man, He humbled Himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross. Ipinakita po sa atin ng verse na binasa natin today, ng mga verses na yan, na dahil sa pagmamahal sa atin ng Diyos, ng ating Panginoong Jesus, He spent time with us on the earth. At mula dito sa example na ito, may kita po natin ang kahalagahan ng spending time with those whom we have given our commitment. Kaya pag sinabi po natin that we are committed, we commit our presence, we are present, we give our time. At hindi lang basta-basta time. Binibigay natin ang tinatawag nating committed people, give quality time. Sabi ni Arthur Schopenhauer, ordinary people think merely how they will spend their time. A man of intellect tries to use it. May mga tao na sabi nila, kasama naman nila tayo, ngunit hindi naman natin nararamdaman na tunay nga natin silang kasama. Pwedeng abalang-abala sa pagtitext, o di naman kaya, ang tanaw ay napakalayo, o habang tayo nag-uusap, hindi naman niya naririnig ang ating mga sinasabi. Nakakalungkot, dahil kapiling natin, ngunit hindi natin kasama. We can do this to our loved ones. We can do this to our husband, our wife, our children, our friends, our leaders, and even when you're inside a church, pwedeng nandudoon ka na sa loob, ngunit hindi mo naman pinakikinggan intently yung nangangaral. Ang isipan natin lumilipad kung saan-saan. Kung mahalaga sa atin ang tao, kung mahalaga sa atin ang isang bagay, we give it not only our time, but we give it our quality time. What else? Committed people make time. Sabi ni Charles Buxton, you will never find time for anything. If you want time, you must make it. Totoo naman po, sa gusto, maraming paraan. Sa ayaw, isang katerba ang dahilan. If we love someone, if we love something, we're committed to it, it means we make time for it. What else? Committed people rarely, if at all, waste time. On Valuing Time by Lord Chesterfield, know the true value of time. Snatch, seize and enjoy every moment of it. No idleness, no laziness, no procrastination. Never put off till tomorrow what you can do today. Committed people, hindi sila nagsasayang ng kanilang oras. Hindi na maibig sabihin na parang robot na sila na hindi na nagpapahinga. Ngunit alam nilang disiplinahin ang kanilang katawan. Alam nila ayusin ang kanilang schedule so that the most important things in their life na gagawa nila, na fulfill nila because they are truly committed. What else? Committed people, what do they do? Commitment involves our participation, meaning our talents. Jesus gave his talents, words and acts. John 21, verse 25. Jesus did many other things as well. If every one of them were written down, I suppose that even the whole world would not have room for the books that would be written. Anong ibig sabihin nito? Role model pa rin natin si Jesus. Nung siya'y naririto sa lupa, hindi lang siya nag-aksaya ng oras, hindi lang siya nagbakasyon. But more importantly, he said many things, he did many things. When he said he loved us, he did something about it. When he said that he was committed, he participated. He did something. Why? Because committed people participate through words or ideas. Sabi ni Julian Sorrell Huxley, words are tools which automatically carve concepts out of experiences. Ang tao na committed, nag-iisip yan at may sinasabi. Hindi lang niya ito iniisip, binibigkas niya ito. He gives his opinion, he gives his suggestions, he gives ideas. This is very, very important. And what else? Committed people participate through actions or abilities. Sabi ni John Locke, I have always thought the actions of men the best interpreters of their thoughts. Mahalaga na may idea, mahalaga na may opinion, pero mas importante sa marami ang action. Kaya ang tao na truly committed, he does not only give his opinion, but he involves himself and he participates to show that his commitment is true and sincere. And what else? Committed people participate through prayer or acts of faith. Sabi ni Saint Augustine, pray as though everything depended on God. Work as though everything depended on you. May ginagawa tayo, we do our very best, but we pray. We have faith. We believe that with our commitment, itong commitment na ito ay nakikita rin dahil sa ating pag-commit sa panalangin. What else? Pag meron tayong commitment, commitment generates provision. Meaning, our treasure. Jesus gave his treasure, his blood. 1 Corinthians 11, 23-26. For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, this is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it, in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until He comes. Makikita po natin na dahil committed si Jesus sa atin, He gave His treasure, He gave His blood. Because committed people are passionate givers. Sabi ni Sir Winston Churchill, I have nothing to offer but blood, toil, tears, and sweat. May kanya-kanya po tayong pwedeng i-offer. Pero kadalasan, hindi lang mahalaga yung ating in-offer, pero mahalaga rin kung paano natin ito in-offer. And in this particular quotation by Winston Churchill, at pati na rin dun sa verses that showed to us how committed Jesus is to us by dying for us, by shedding His blood, we are reminded that if we are truly committed, we are passionate givers. And what else? Committed people are not selfish. Sabi ni Tertullian, he who lives only to benefit himself confers on the world a benefit when he dies. Nakakalungkot na nagdidiwang pa ang mga tao pag nawala na tayo dito sa lupa. Dahil naging selfish tayo. Even if we had so many blessings, we did not share it with others. Mahalaga po sa buhay na tayo nag-i-invest, na tayo ay gumagawa ng kabutihan. Dahil sa ating investment of goodness, bumabalik din ito sa atin. That's why committed people, they are never selfish. They are generous, they give. And committed people are generous because they love. Sabi sa atin ni Amy Carmichael, you can give without loving, but you cannot love without giving. Ipinapakita po sa atin ng quotation na ating binasa kung gaano kahalaga na sa ating commitment nakikita that we are generous. We are generous not because we boast. We generous not because we want to impress, but we are generous because we love. Hindi po natin pwede alisin na ito ay mahalagang aspeto ng commitment na tayo nagbibigay. Hindi lamang sa money, hindi lamang sa material possessions, but more importantly, with the sincerity of our love for others. Kaya sabi sa atin ng isang poem, ng isang tula ni Margaret Sangster na pinangalan ng The Sin of Omission. It isn't the thing you do, dear. It's the thing you leave undone that gives you a bit of a heartache at setting of the sun. The tender work forgotten, the letter you did not write, the flowers you did not send, dear, are your haunting ghosts at night. The stone you might have lifted out of a brother's way, the bit of heartsome counsel you were hurried too much to say, the loving touch of the hand, dear, the gentle, winning tone, which you had no time nor thought for, with troubles enough of your own. Those little acts of kindness, so easily out of mind. Those chances to be angels, which we poor mortals find. They come in night and silence, each sad, reproachful wraith, when hope is faint and flagging, and a chill has fallen on faith. For life is all too short, dear, and sorrow is all too great to suffer our slow compassion that tarries until too late. And it isn't the thing you do, dear, it's the thing you leave undone, which gives you a bit of heartache at the setting of a sun. 1 Peter 4:19. So then, those who suffer according to God's will should commit themselves to their faithful Creator and continue to do good. Let us pray. Aming Diyos at aming Ama, salamat po sa aming mga pinag-aralan sa araw na ito. Pinaalalahanan mo po kami ng kahalagahan na dapat kaming mag-commit sa aming Panginoon. Na nakikita ang aming commitment because we are willing to show this commitment. Pinapakita natin when we give our time, our presence. Pinapakita namin when we give our provisions. Pinapakita namin when we participate by giving our actions. Lord, teach us. Kayo magturo sa amin kung paano ba maging truly committed. At patawarin mo po kami sa mga oras na kami ay hindi nagpakita ng tamang commitment sa mga bagay na napakahalaga sa buhay. Sa aming relationships with our loved ones, sa aming mga trabaho, sa aming pag-aaral, sa aming ministry, at pinaka-importante sa lahat, sa aming relationship with God. We seek your forgiveness. Enable us, after this devotional, to once again renew our commitment to God. Help us, Lord, to be truly committed to you. And we dedicate to you the rest of the day. Lahat ng aming mga pagsubok sa buhay, lahat ng aming mga challenges in life, we offer unto you. As we pray all of these things and believe that today is a blessed day, in Jesus' name, amen.